Let's talk about fasting and what happens to your body when you fast. Because the benefits, they don't all happen at once. Some start earlier in the fast and some kick in a bit later. So depending on your goals and your lifestyle, it might be more suitable to fast for shorter or longer periods of time. Now we all know that fasting can be beneficial for weight loss, but it comes with other benefits as well. It can reduce inflammation, improve brain and body function, slow down aging, increase metabolism, and contribute to the reversal of insulin resistance, even preventing diabetes and other diseases. And this is just scratching the surface of the amazing benefits that fasting has to offer. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about the different stages of fasting, both when you're doing intermittent fasting and extended fasting. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a certified health and nutrition coach. I post new videos twice a week here on YouTube talking all things insulin resistance, weight loss, sleep, and more. So if you're ready to take control of your metabolic health, make sure to click that subscribe button. And you can also find me on TikTok and Instagram where I share new posts every single day. The topic of today is fasting and the different stages along the timeline. Fasting is defined as the willful refrainment from eating. So anytime you're not eating, you're fasting. We're all fasting when we sleep, but honestly, a lot of us are not spending much time fasting otherwise. This is partly to do with the fact that we've all been conditioned to think we need to eat breakfast first thing in the morning, and also to do with the fact that a lot of us are guilty with late night snacking as well. Because of this, most of us spend the majority of our day in a fed state, and we're missing out on the benefits that come from being in a fasted one. Now, there are two main types of fasting, and within these, there are several variations. There is intermittent fasting and extended fasting. Intermittent fasting is when you have a fasting schedule and you fast for a certain amount of time each day. The most popular variation is 16-8, where you don't eat for 16 hours, including time spent sleeping, and you eat all of your calories for the day within an 8-hour window. But intermittent fasting can range anywhere from 12 to 24 hours. Now, when you fast for longer than 24 hours, this is going to be an extended fast. This is when a lot of the benefits that go beyond weight loss are going to start to ramp up. The difference with extended fasting is it only needs to be done periodically to reap the benefits. Depending on the length of your extended fast, you might only need to do one monthly, quarterly, or even yearly. If you do extended fasting too frequently, you're going to start to get diminishing returns, especially if you're a woman or if you have a low body fat percentage. Longer does not always equal better. Now, before we really get into the meat of this video, I'm going to answer a question that I'm frequently asked, and that is, how do you track your fast and what is the best app to use? Personally, my favorite app is Fastic. Fastic is dedicated to making healthy living accessible to everyone. Losing weight while developing healthy habits has never been easier. Besides allowing you to actually track your fast, Fastic is also loaded with helpful tools to educate and challenge you. As you progress through your fast, Fastic allows you to see the different stages and the benefits you're receiving, which we're going to be talking about in depth in today's video. I love the fasting tracker because it really helps you to visualize your progress. Fastic recommends starting with a 14-10 schedule if you're a beginner and easing yourself into longer fasts if those align with your goals. Whether your goals are fat loss, increased energy, or generally feeling stronger, Fastic can provide the support, encouragement, and accountability you need. All you have to do is click the link that's in the top of the description box down below, and according to your weight, height, and age, you're going to get a personalized fasting and meal plan. And then you can relax, because the app is going to remind you about your fasting and eating times. Download the app now for free and say goodbye to fad diets and start fasting with Fastic. But anyways, thank you Fastic for sponsoring this video. Now let's get into the different stages and benefits of fasting. So the first stage of fasting, or I guess the stage before the fast officially begins, is the fed state. We are in a fed state when we have eaten and our bodies are digesting our food. Now, one question I'm asked a lot is, does your fast start when you stop eating, or does it start once you've digested your last meal? And I mean, it's really impossible to know when your body has fully processed the last thing you ate. So it's easier to just start your fast as soon as you stop eating your last meal. So the fed state is the opposite of the fasted state. During this state, your blood sugar increases as your food is broken down, and insulin is released to bring the excess blood sugar to your cells. Ghrelin, the hunger hormone, decreases during this time, and leptin, the satiety hormone, increases. Your body is digesting the food and absorbing the nutrients. Now, as I said before, you can't really tell when you've left a fed state. It's going to depend on what you last ate for your last meal, how big the meal was, your activity level, your metabolism, so many factors. So just assume that your fasting window starts as soon as you finish your last bite of food. Now, the next stage happens around the 4 to 8 hour mark. This is when your blood sugar and insulin levels drop down to baseline. Now, I will say that this stage also depends on a lot of factors, mainly the food you ate going into the fast. If you are generally eating a keto or low carb diet, for example, these diets actually mimic fasting in a lot of ways, and one of the main ways being that they don't raise blood sugar or insulin significantly. So of course, someone following one of these diets is going to see their blood sugar and insulin return to baseline quicker than someone who is eating a higher carbohydrate diet. And keep this in mind as we go through the video, because it basically just means that anyone who is eating a low carb diet in general, all of these stages are going to happen earlier. Now, around the 12 hour mark is when the next stage starts. This is when we start to see significant increases in the release of human growth hormone. Human growth hormone helps to regulate body composition, body fluids, muscle and bone growth, and sugar and fat metabolism. When we're in a fed state, the secretion of human growth hormone is significantly lower. And this is why a lot of people only really experience a large release in human growth hormone when they're sleeping, because most of us spend so much time in a fed state. Now, up until this point, your body has been using the food from your last meal for energy, along with stored glucose. But around the 16-hour mark is when this stored glucose starts to run out. At this point, your body begins looking for an alternative energy source, which is when it will begin to pull from your fat stores and produce ketones. Of course, this means that you're beginning to burn body fat for energy, which is good for weight loss if that's your goal. But ketones have additional benefits as well. Reduced inflammation, increased mental clarity, more stable blood sugar. They help to reverse insulin resistance, and they can help to increase your endurance performance. The next stage starts to happen around the 18 to 20 hour mark. This is when autophagy starts to really kick in. Now, what is autophagy, you might be asking? Autophagy is a cellular process where the body cleans out damaged cells and regenerates new ones. You can think of it like this. The cells in your body aren't meant to last forever, just like the parts in your car. At some point, they're going to become worn down and need to be replaced. For example, if your car gets a flat tire, you're gonna want to replace it. Your car's not gonna work very well if you're driving around and you ignore the flat. And the same goes for your cells. If one of them becomes damaged, things aren't gonna work properly. The cell needs to be replaced. And this is what autophagy is for. Now, around the 36-hour mark, autophagy really starts to ramp up. Studies have shown that it can increase up to 300% at this time. And this means that your body is working in overtime to recycle your damaged cells. This is really beneficial for disease prevention and even healing from disease. Autophagy has also been shown to increase longevity. Now, at the 48-hour mark, human growth hormone starts to really ramp up to 500%. So again, this helps with maintaining lean muscle mass, your body composition, etc. Okay, so now if you've made it to the 54-hour mark, this is when you're going to see the most significant benefits in your insulin sensitivity. Now, I have so many videos on my channel on insulin resistance. I'll link one above if you want to know more about it. But basically, something you should know is that most people nowadays are insulin resistant and don't even know it. And this is a problem because insulin resistance is at the root of most modern day diseases. It makes weight loss difficult. It causes blood sugar dysregulation. It can lead to PCOS, heart disease, type 2 diabetes, Alzheimer's. And something that a lot of people don't know is that insulin resistance is the same thing as metabolic syndrome, which you're probably more familiar with. Metabolic syndrome actually used to be called insulin resistance syndrome. But anyways, the point is, if you are insulin resistant, you want to become more insulin sensitive because this can help to reverse it. And fasting is the best way to improve your insulin sensitivity. Now, I will say that any amount of fasting, even 12 hours, 14 hours, intermittent fasting can definitely be beneficial for improving insulin sensitivity. But at this 54-hour mark, it really starts to improve. Now, moving on, around the 72-hour mark is when autophagy peaks. And this is probably a good time for most people to end their fast. There are definitely benefits that come from fasting longer, mainly in regards to disease healing. But in general, I think that 72 hours is the sweet spot for extended fasting. If you do continue on though, from 72 hours to about 120 hours, this is when stem cell activity is going to be maximized. Fasting dramatically improves our stem cells' ability to regenerate new immune system cells. Animal studies and a couple of human studies have shown a decrease in risk for cancer and a decrease in cancer growth rates from fasting because of this. And those are the different stages and benefits of fasting. Let me know in the comment section down below what your current fasting routine looks like. Are you going to switch it up after watching this video? Let me know in the comments down below. And before you go, don't forget to download the Fastic app for free. Again, the link is going to be in the top of the description box. If you did like this video, you might also like my video on how you can increase your metabolic flexibility. You can check it out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my coaching programs, including my 7-day insulin resistance masterclass, you can find those here. Thanks guys, I'll see you next time. Bye.